This presentation brought to you by Michelob Ultra. Michelob Ultra. I wish someone would.
Hey guys, Happy New Year. Happy New Year to my boy Yorkshire MGTOW. Happy New Year to my boy MGTOW Universe. And a special Happy New Year to my newest subscriber. Let's start the year off with something fun. How about a cringe joke?
Hello, folks. What do you call an old school acca? Haagen-Dazs.
Thank you, Mr. Tumbledee. So, this cringe joke I came up with today, and I just don't know how to give good delivery on it, and it's a pretty decent joke. I just want to say it just anyway. So the joke, basically, this is what happened. I was at work, and in an all parts retail store, generally what you do if our store doesn't have it or your store doesn't have it, you look up on the district list of who's got the part, etc., and then you send them over there. And what a lot of my coworkers do, or I should say extended coworkers do, is they'll just send them over to where I am. It'll just be happenstance. But when they come over, I'm kind of like, oh, did they give you a part number? No. You know, they give you any kind of slip? No. So now when I have a unruly customer and it just so happens that their princess is in another castle, I'll print out a slip and then I'll hand it to them and say, and now I've given you the slip. So as I was trying to rush out a video before New Year's Eve, which needless to say I failed at, I found something on my old laptop, my really, really old one, and it was me and my brother, and we were sitting down, and we were riffing Puma Man, as the real title's Puma Man, from MST3, or presented to us by MST3K. The audio is terrible, so it's really great that I have, like, all of the equipment and tools to do what I'm about to do, because, you know, I can update this concept and I can bring it to fruition. So here it goes.
So the curse can strike you too.
I always prefer to strike first.
Brov, how are you gonna be like even one step ahead of a curse, brov? Brov's talking about, like, taking something that's, like, incorporeal, son, then, like, bringing it to this plane of existence, bro, and then, like, choking it down or whatever.
Straight shameful, bro.
And now to sail us away, we have a little mini skit, or a kind of a preview skit of a little upcoming segment or video I'm going to do called The Ballot of Coach Bane. I'll never forget the time Coach Bane came to campus. He wasn't a complete monster, just a guy who went way too far to prove his point. After being interrupted one day yet a third time during his particle physics symposium, he would go on to snap yet another student's neck. At this point, the dean of the university had finally had it and called Coach Bane up to his office. As he was leaving, the newly rendered quadriplegic student had asked Coach Bane, "Why the neck?" Coach Bane simply responded, "You were expecting the backbreaker, so I was merely subverting your expectations."
"Yeah, I remember Coach Bane. Talking all that fandom shit, talking about order and structure. If it ain't in my playbook, I ain't gonna play."